السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على عبده ورسوله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا بكم. I welcome my dear brothers and sisters in Al-Islam to the beginning of the A to Z of Zakah and Siyam series insha'Allah. Ya Abdallah, Ya Amat Allah, بإذن الله تعالى, we will be going through the manners, the etiquettes, the fiqh, the masail of fasting and the matters related to paying off your zakah in the alphabetical order, walhamdulillah. Ya Abdallah, Ya Amat Allah, if we have to talk about the matters of siyam, the matters of zakah, we know that generally these matters revolve around the beautiful month of Ramadan. Ya Abdallah, Ya Amat Allah, that is that season of change. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us this month every single year so that we can make a change in our lives. It is the month of tarbiyah. It's a madrasa of change, walhamdulillah. If, for example, we had a brother or a sister, suddenly on a Monday morning, they changed their lives, or for example, on a Thursday evening, they changed their lives, then people would question, what happened, brother? All of a sudden, you have this massive change in you? But subhanallah, if after the month of Ramadan, now that you've gone through this madrasa, you've completely changed your life for the better, people understand. People know. In fact, people expect you to change, Ya Abdallah, Ya Amatallah. But unfortunately, some only change their lives for the month of Ramadan. And as they are called, Ramadaniyun, they are Ramadan Muslims only. Ya Abdallah, Ya Amatallah, worse would be that individual who even in the month of Ramadan continues upon the wrong that he's been upon for the rest of the year. If Iblis is locked up in this month of Ramadan, what excuse do we have? Allahu musta'an. May Allah forgive our past and present sins. Ya Abdallah, Ya Amatallah. We begin bi-ithnillahi ta'ala. When we want to talk about the matters of Siyam, the matters of Zakah, we begin with A. And A is for what? A is for none other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Khaliq, the Raziq, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Sustainer, the Nourisher, the Owner of the heavens and the earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Maliki Yawmiddin, Owner of the final day, the Day of Judgment. Ya Abdallah, Ya Amatallah, it is Allah who created us, and it is Him who sent the various messengers. And our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the final of them all, in his revelation in the noble Quran, it states that our reason for creation is what? Is that we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا خَلَقَتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, except that they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Abdallah, Ya Amat Allah, in this month of Ramadan, in this time of fasting, when you want to pay your zakah, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number one, do it for the sake of Allah. Do it with ikhlas and upon the way taught to us by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Abdallah, Ya Amat Allah, if A is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is supposed to be in our minds at all times. We're supposed to be conscious of the fact that Allah is watching me. As a scholar, he said, brother, if you want to sin, no problem, sin. But find a place that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not be able to see you. Ya Abdallah, Ya Amatallah, we know the errors of our past. We know the errors of our present. Allahu musta'an. And it is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His mercy, that He's covered up our sins from the rest of the people. The speaker, even before those being spoken to, Ya Abdallah, Ya Amatallah, one of the ulama, he said, that if my sins had an odor to it, if my sins had a stench to it, then people would run away from me. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His infinite mercy, He's covered it up. And so the people, they have good thoughts of us, when in reality, the reality is something else. When Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an was praised to his face, what would he say? He would say that, Allahumma la tu'akhidni bima yaqulun, واغفر لي ما لا يعلمون وجعلني خيرا مما يظنون. سبحان الله. Oh Allah, do not hold me accountable with regards to what they say about me, and make me better than what they think about me, and forgive me for what they do not know about me. اللهم لا تؤاخذني بما يقولون واغفر لي ما لا يعلمون واجعلني خيرا مما يظنون. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that our siyam past and present, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts it, that Allah grants us ikhlas, for verily it is a war waged against Iblis, who wants us to have riya in our acts of worship. He wants you to give that zakah with the intention that you are giving this man and you must get some sort of benefit from this individual. That he should say, MashaAllah, the organization should state that, MashaAllah, you always give so much of zakah. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, give with the right hand so that the left hand does not even know. That is A, and A is for none other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A is also for annually. And the matter of the month of Ramadan comes annually. We fast 1 month a year, which is an obligation. Obviously, every Monday and Thursday it is sunnah to fast. 3 days in every month also sunnah to fast, walhamdulillah. But as for the obligatory fast, it is 1 month in the year, and that's the month of Ramadan. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, kutiba alaykum as-siyam kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum. That siyam has been prescribed, written down upon you, like it was for the people before you. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, this is the madrasa of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and Jibreel, they would revise the Quran every year in the month of Ramadan. And in the final Ramadan of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam's life, they revised the noble Quran twice, subhanallah. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, the month of Ramadan comes once a year. And the matter of zakah also occurs only once a year. Obviously, zakah is not dependent upon the month of Ramadan. Maybe, for example, you became sahibul nisab, you became a person of zakatable wealth, maybe in the month of Muharram. So every year in the month of Muharram, if you are above the nisab, then you need to pay your zakah. But because we don't really work so much with the Hijri calendar, it works out much easier for most people to pay their zakah in the month of Ramadan. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, out of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these two pillars of Al-Islam, we only have to do them, perform them once a year. We fast in the month of Ramadan, and many of us pay our zakah in the month of Ramadan. Imagine if we had to do this every third month, Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah. It would be difficult upon us. La yukallifu Allahu nafsan illa wus'aha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not burden a soul more than it can bear. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah. A was for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The beginning, the end, we remember Allah. A also for the matter of fasting, the matter of zakah, we sort it out annually and not every month or every week. We move on bi-ithnillahi ta'ala to the letter B. And B, when it comes to fasting or zakah, B stands for what? B stands for subhanallah, B stands for bleeding. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah. We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written this matter of the menses upon the daughters of Adam alayhi salam. And thus the female every month, she would bleed for duration of time. And during this time, she is not allowed to fast. During this time, she is not allowed to perform salah. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah. The sister does not fast during the days of her menses. Rather, she would make up qada. She would do these fasts after the month of Ramadan, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. With regards to the female who is in istihada, she has this chronic discharge, she has this chronic bleeding. It's nothing to do with her menses. Maybe she's emotionally upset. Maybe, for example, she is ill and she has this continuous discharge. Does it affect the validity of her fasting? Absolutely not. In fact, intimacy between husband and wife allowed when the wife is in istihada. The fast allowed, she has to fast when she's in istihada. Salah is not maf, rather she has to perform her salah when she is in istihada. All those exceptional rules only apply when she is in her menstruation, when she is bleeding the blood of menses. So there's no fasting, She does not make tawaf around the Kaaba according to majority of the scholars. She's not allowed to fast. She's not allowed to perform salah. These matters she is excluded from. She is excused from those matters when she is in her menses. What does she do? After the month of Ramadan, she makes qada of those fasts. And a reminder to our sisters out there, that try your utmost best to make sure that you perform and you've done these qada fasts before the next Ramadan. Subhanallah, how many a sister comes along and she says that, I have about 100 fasts owing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the past 3, 4, 5 years. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, do not fall into that mistake. Before the next Ramadan, make sure that you have completed all of your qada, walhamdulillah. So A was for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A was also for fasting and paying the zakah annually. And B was for the matter of bleeding. And B is also for breastfeeding. Maybe our sisters out there, in this month of Ramadan, she is breastfeeding her kid. Does she fast? No, she does not have to fast, subhanallah. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, what happens is, after the month of Ramadan, or after the breastfeeding period is over, then the sister, she makes qada of those fasts, walhamdulillah. Let's say she missed 2 weeks of fasting. After Ramadan, she sorts out those 2 weeks, bi-ithnillahi ta'ala. You cannot pay the fidya. Fidya is only for those individuals who are unable to fast. As for yourself, alhamdulillah, you are able. Even if it be 6 months later, you have the ability, so you have to fast, insha'Allah. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam. With that, bi-ithnillahi ta'ala, we take a break. Hayyakumullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome, my dear brothers and sisters in al-Islam. We continue bi-ithnillahi ta'ala. We move on to C, bi-ithnillahi ta'ala. C is for what? C is for the collection of zakah. Brothers and sisters, we know in the old days that the khulafa, they would send out the zakah collectors to the various cities and various towns. We know that during the caliphate of Abu Bakr radiallahu anh, there were certain individuals who said, we will make salah, but we will not pay the zakah. Zakah collectors would come and they would not give anything. What did Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala do? Leave them? Let them be? Absolutely not. Rather, he readied up the army and he went and faced them. He said that, I would face and fight the one who differentiates between salah and zakah. If they used to give to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam and they do not want to give now, then we will fight them until they do so. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, why? Because number one, it's a pillar of Al-Islam. And number two, because that wealth is the haq of the poor. Once the time of zakah comes, that wealth ceases to be your wealth. That 2.5% is no longer yours. Rather, it belongs to the poor. And thus, the qadi or the judge, or for example, the hakim, the one in charge, sends the zakah collected. It is their right to take it from you and give it to the poor because they are the ones who are deserving of it. In fact, because it belongs to them now. Walhamdulillah. Collection of zakah. Fast forward to the year, let's say 2014. Is it allowed, for example, myself to say that I am a zakah collector? Salim, he also does his own zakah collection. And Ahmed does his zakah collection. And then what do? And then we say, well, you know what, for our efforts, we will take a cut of maybe 15% or 20%. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. To Allah we belong and to Him we return. Brothers and sisters, this is absolutely haram. This is totally impermissible. Had this been permissible, every individual, Salim, Ahmed, Ilyas, would stand up, Sumayya also, and Salihah too. They would all stand up and say, you know what, we're leaving our jobs. We're going to become zakah collectors, self-appointed zakah collectors. And we will collect, and then we will take a cut on whatever we collect, 5%, 10%. Brothers and sisters, this is not allowed. The zakah collectors are to be appointed by the state. It is not something that you appoint yourself. If, for example, you want to help out people and you want to collect the zakah and give it to a worthy cause, no problem at all. But the issue comes in when you start taking a cut for the collection, when you start taking a payment for the collection. 5%, 2%, 1% of whatever you've collected, that's totally impermissible. A brother might say, well, in the noble Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states that one of those individuals who's allowed to take of zakah are the collectors. We say, brother, that's the zakah collectors who have been appointed by the state, not your self-appointed zakah collector. Otherwise, every unemployed individual would say, you know what, I'm doing zakah collection and I take a cut for myself, mashallah, and he lives his life like that. Not permissible, would open up the door to fitna and fasad. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, as we said, C was for collection of this zakah. Another important point is that many a zakah body or zakah organization, they collect zakah during the year, and unfortunately, they do not dispense of that money before the end of the year. And so they're sitting on millions and millions which have not yet been distributed. Subhanallah. Brothers and sisters, remember, if there's a poor brother out there, if there's a sister out there, and they are in need, and you are sitting on their money, in reality, you are sitting on their money, because that money is supposed to be going to them to alleviate their situation. If you are sitting with their money and not distributing it to them, then you are sinful before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You would have to answer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That brother, that sister on Yawm al-Qiyamah could say to Allah, oh Allah, I suffered because they did not distribute that which was mine. It's not theirs. It does not belong to the zakah organization. Rather, it is the haq of the poor and it is supposed to reach them. It is supposed to be distributed to them. So see, Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah was for the collection of the zakah. C is also for concessions, subhanallah. And there are certain individuals who are granted concessions when it comes to the matter of fasting, for example. So we have temporary excuse and permanent excuse. Those who have a temporary concession and others who have a permanent concession. Temporary concession, for example, the individual who has an illness, and this is an illness that he hopes to recover from. Maybe, for example, he's got the flu. Maybe, for example, he's injured his arm. Maybe, for example, he's got a fever. So this is a temporary illness, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. So the individual is allowed to break their fast. They are allowed not to fast. Walhamdulillah. What do they do? After the month of Ramadan, they make qada. Simple as that. The next one, the one who is a musafir, the traveler. And thus the traveler also not obliged to fast in the month of Ramadan. And after the month of Ramadan, they would make qada, walhamdulillah. Simple as that. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah. Those are but a few examples of the temporary excuse. Another one would be the sister who is in her menses. So she does not fast because she has a temporary excuse. After the month of Ramadan, she would make qada. So for temporary excuse, we have qada. But when it comes to permanent excuse, the brother might be 20 years old, but he's got a terminal illness. And the doctors have said to him that, brother, you cannot fast. It is detrimental to your health. So he has a permanent excuse. He will not fast the month of Ramadan. So would he make qada? No, he cannot make qada because it's a permanent excuse. Give him 5 years, 10 years, nothing's going to change. So what does he do? He does the fidya. He sorts out the fidya. He feeds one poor Muslim for every single day that he did not fast. Similarly, the individual who is very, very old. So the sister, she might be at the age of 90, very, very frail, unable to fast. Does she have a temporary excuse or permanent? Permanent excuse, no doubt. And so what do? They feed a poor Muslim for every day that they did not fast. That's the fidya, walhamdulillah. So Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, concessions are divided into two categories. Temporary concessions and permanent concessions. Those who have a temporary excuse, those with a permanent excuse. Examples of temporary excuse, the traveler, the one who has an illness that he hopes to recover from, the female who is in her menses, the female who is breastfeeding her kid, they have a temporary excuse. What do? Qada after the month of Ramadan. As for permanent excuse, then they only have the option of fidya, walhamdulillah. We move on to the next matter, And that is the letter D. What does D stand for? D stands for debts, subhanAllah. And as has been said, a debt is like death. It is like death. For verily the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he will pray janazah upon all people, but there were certain individuals that he did not pray their janazah over. Who? The one who had debt, subhanAllah. The one who committed suicide, he also did not pray over them. To show the gravity of this matter. يُغْفَرُ لِلشَّهِيدِ كُلُّ ذَنْبِ إِلَّا الدَّيْنِ All of the sins of the martyr, they are forgiven, except the matter of debt. Allahu musta'an. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah. When it comes to debts and zakah, you find that we have two categories. Debts which you owe and debts owed to you. As for debts which you owe, then when you are calculating your zakah, you minus that amount. If it is to be paid within the next 12 months, so whatever of debt, and a debt is something which is already due on your head. We're not talking about a light account which is yet to be due. We're not talking about an electricity bill which would come 3 months from now. But rather we are talking about a debt, we are talking about an amount which is due from you already. Alhamdulillah. So when it comes to debts which are due, then they are divided into long-term debts and short-term debts. Short-term debts, you wipe them away and you minus them from your assets. As for long-term debt, you only minus the amount which is due in this year, within the next 12 months. Not more than that. Because many of us today, we have long-term debts. And if we had to minus the entire amount, we would find that maybe we are liable to collect zakah and not liable to pay zakah. Allahu musta'an. So Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, with regards to debts, we will discuss now, inshaAllah, the matter of debts which are owed by you. You need to pay up this amount. We said that long-term debt, you minus only that which is due for the next 12 months. As for short-term debt, you can minus the entire amount. So this means if you minus your debts, you would obviously be paying less zakah because there's less assets that you have. Because the debt is money which does not even belong to you. It belongs to someone else. Walhamdulillah. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, when we meet again, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, we will discuss debts which are owed to you. And that's an asset, subhanAllah. So we need to add it to our assets in our zakah collection, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Jazakumullahu khayran. Remember, if your knowledge is above average, your ibadah is also supposed to be above average. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allah, Allah, you are my Lord. I bow to you. Allah, Allah, you are my Lord. I bow to you. Allah, Allah, you are my Lord.